I'm here with one of the legends of Turkish chess. I am Can Arduman. Can, you have won the Turkish Championship a record 6 times.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes, correct.
From which years?
1993, 1994, 1996, 1997, 1998 and 2002.
And this record has never been broken?
Until now, no.
Who are the other, someone who has won
there
it multiple times?
There is also a guy, international master, Turhan Yilmaz, 5 times.
Okay.
The nearest one. So, the rest is 3 times.
So can you tell us like how you were able to become such a strong player? Because now Turkey has 13 GMs, but I guess when
yes.
you were...
Yes, at that time there was no GMs. Later on, Suat Atalık became GM. But when I was playing, actually, it was very difficult situation. You know, there were no computers. We didn't have any trainer. We trained ourselves. And also the traveling around also was difficult because the federation didn't have any money. And it was a private federation, not attached to the government. So in order to go to the abroad, to the tournaments, we needed to spend our money, you know. And we were only able to go to the team tournaments because they were paying for us, for the Olympiads, for the Balkaniad tournaments, and some other junior championships. But if you want to go to open tournaments, you should pay from your own pocket.
So that was
So
difficult.
It was very difficult. And I was going only one tournament or 2 tournaments maximum per year.
And maybe that's the reason why you couldn't become a GM.
Exactly. And also I didn't have any trainer, which was actually incredibly difficult to work by yourself, you know. We had a chess club, we were going there, all the good players. Actually, it was very good for me because all the best players of Turkey was in that club
in
Istanbul. Yes.
Okay. And when you started to play well, who were the people who helped you to improve?
Usually my friends, they were at my level, most of them, because we didn't have too much difference at that time. So we were working together, and also I was buying mini books. I had around 1,000 books at my home. So
well, I saw you buying a lot of books
yes,
just a few
I
minutes
loved
ago.
Yes, I loved it, yes, to buy books. I was reading the books, and from the books also I was learning a lot, you know. And one of the most loved books of mine, it was the Think Like a Grandmaster from Kotov. Then I translated it in Turkish together
really?
With Play Like a Grandmaster.
Okay.
Now it's the second, actually, times.
Kotov,
yes.
You know him or have you ever contacted him before?
No, I didn't contact him. I just bought the book. I loved the book and I read the book. And it was actually one of the most sold books in the history of chess. Think Like a Grandmaster. It made a big difference in my chess.
Were you able to follow his advice of candidate
yeah.
moves and calculating
exactly.
each variation once?
For me, actually, it was a big difference. I didn't know how to think, how to, plan in chess. You know, he gives lots of advice in this book. How to plan, how to think, how to make coordination of the pieces. All these strategic ideas you can find in this book. And then there is the other book, which is not very known, the Play Like a Grandmaster. And actually, this was not very known. And when I started to translate, I noticed that in English version, it's lacking minimum 30 pages from the Russian version. So my wife is Russian. I made her translate this 30 pages. And the book was actually a complete book. And when you read this book, you understand that this book also is very good. But in English version, they made it not very good.
So you can thank Koto for your improvement to a big extent.
Exactly.
Okay, and have you played Olympiads? How many Olympiads have you played?
Well, I don't remember exactly. Minimum 5.
Minimum 5,
yeah,
and
yeah.
Many of them on the top board?
Yeah, I played some of them on the first board, some of them on the second, some of them on the third.
Any top players of the world that you have played against, do you remember?
I played against Topalov, I drew in Balkaniad. I played against Magnus Carlsen in Crete in a team tournament. He was 13. I lost, but it was the equal position. And in time travel, I made a mistake. He won very nicely with a tactical move. So these are these two champions, world champions. Yes. Yeah.
Absolute mm-hmm. elite.
Yeah.
And you have recently started, we can't say recently, but a few years ago, the commentary in Turkish chess.
Around 5 years ago.
Yeah. And you have set up something really special here. Mm-hmm. The commentary, you commentate every day for the World Juniors. Can you tell us how it began?
Well, actually, I was very much, impressed by this concept, live commentary. And I started to watch it, you know, especially when Şehirevan, you know, he started to make this commentary. I was watching it and I always wondering why we couldn't do it in Turkey. And we started with one camera in our hand. We went to Antalya and there was some championship. And we were, as you are doing now, we are shooting them and then and putting in the, you know, in the Turkish Chess Federation website. But later on, I said that why not to do it in live, you know, because it will be much more interesting. People will watch it and the chess will be, you know, seen everywhere and more people will play chess and it will be much more interesting for them. So we started it. It was with one camera at the playing hall and one camera in the, you know, in the commentating room. So, but later on it became actually bigger and bigger. People actually showed much more interest in this. So as you can see, we are doing it, much better now.
Much is a very understatement. I think you have almost reached a level where it is world class. Because you have all the softwares, all the cameras, and also on the games there are cameras.
Thank you.
So did Turkish chess help you in making this more professional?
Exactly. This, of course, the federation help us a lot. You know, they give all the, conditions. They give us the possibilities to make this live commentary possible. So it's with the help of them we are doing it. But we can do it, of course, much better. You know, I want to do it much better. But of course, everything takes time.
So you plan to continue doing this in the coming years?
Of course, I do.
And Turkey has nearly 800,000 players registered with the federation. Maybe active players are nearly 200,000.
Yeah.
Do you think this live commentary is helping to increase the popularity of the game?
I hope so, because I'm thinking that people showing much interest and they are saying very nice things about this live commentary. As you know, that in the world also, this is now a new concept, you know. If there is a live commentary, people want to see and watch it, you know. And this tournament becomes much more important in the eyes of the people who are playing it also, and also who are watching it and who are attending it, you know. When there is a live commentary, the tournament is more important. So it also gives much more importance to the tournament, to the sponsors. And so it's very important to have a live commentary in a tournament.
Today we saw a young boy from Turkey, Can Işık, become
the youngest
IM in the history of Turkey. Do you feel that now is the time when Turkish chess is going to take those big leaps and become a superpower?
Yes, it's already doing it. You know, 13 grandmasters, as you said, it was incredible. They became grandmaster in 2 or 3 years. It's growing so fast. You know, these kids, you know, they grew up, you see, in 13 years old, they are international master. Probably in the next coming years, they will become grandmasters. So I couldn't imagine such kind of things 20 years or 10 years ago. So it's the last 5 or 6 years it became like this.
And finally, because you have been following this tournament very closely, we have to ask you, who do you think will become champions in the open section and also in the girls? I know in the open it's a no-brainer, but still.
Yeah. Well, in the open section, of course, there is a great player. We all admire him, you know. He is playing an incredible chess, Parham Maksutlu. Well, of course, now he has 1.5 points difference with the rest of the field. So I think in the last coming rounds, he will have minimum and half points. So I don't think it will be a big surprise for anyone. So in the girls section, actually, it's, everything is open. Everything can be 5 players with 7 points. So it was open, tournament. Russian girls, they are playing very well. As you can see, Mr. Faruk Amanatov, he is the coach of them. And I am thinking that one of the Russian players will get this girls world championship, you know, junior championship. But I don't know which one. Okay. I cannot say it.
Sure. Thank you so much, Jan, for entertaining us with your commentary and also for your valuable time right now.
Thank you.